Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day.
Timirandasya Gyananjana Salakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Guruve Nama Sri Chaitanya Mano Bhishta Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Itinamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Pachata Desha Tarine Sri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Sva Padantikam He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesh Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchan Gaurangi Radhe Vrinda Vaneshwari Vrushabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpataru Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Vyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namah Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivas Adi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare
Hare Krishna. So Bengali translation is 98.5 and Hindi translation is 2 minutes mein shuru hone wala hai, wo 97 mein shuru hoga. 97 mein Hindi.
Namam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesh Shunyavadi Pachata Deshatarine. So, I'm sure you are all knowing the subject. I don't know whether it is announced or not. sadhu sangha. So that will be the subject for next hour or so. So why should we know about sadhu sangha? Why should we have sadhu sangha? So the root of knowing this is that we are spirit soul, atma, and atma always looking for bliss. Where is bliss? Where is bliss? Where is bliss? So Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam, the very first question is Kena Atma Samprasiddhati. How a living entity can become totally satisfied, blissful, happy, peaceful? That's the very first question in first canto, first chapter, and first question. So unless the ans goes to ansi, the part and parcel goes back to the whole whom he is part of and have built up relationship, there cannot be any question of total satisfaction, samprasiddhati. Just like this hand wants to remain peaceful, blissful, happy, then first thing this hand has to do is sambandha. Then prayojan and abhideya, sambandha. So living entity has sambandha with Krishna. Living entity is part and parcel of Krishna. So in order to become totally satisfied, the living entity has to go back to Krishna. So the answer is in the third chapter, first canto. And you all know very well that verse. Savai punso paro dharma yato bhaktir adokshaje ahaitukya pratihataya atma samprasiddhati. So atma prasiddhati, yayatma samprasiddhati. How the living entity can become totally satisfied, blissful, happy, peaceful? Then answer is that living entity to engage in devotional service to Krishna. Yato bhaktir adokshaje. And that bhakti should be uninterrupted and unmotivated. Then a living entity can become totally peaceful, blissful. So, yato bhakti radokshaje. Where can we find this bhakti? We have to get this bhakti from somewhere. In order to execute it, to serve Krishna. So then answer is sadhu sangha, sadhu sangha. Sarva sastra koi, lava matra sadhu sangha, sarva siddhi hoy. that we need to somehow or other get association of devotees. So then, how you can get the association of devotees? So then scripture says that Krishna Bhakti Janma Mula Hoya Sadhu Sangha. The association of devotees, that's a birthplace of devotional service to Krishna Bhakti. Krishna Bhakti Janma Mool Hoya Sadhu Sangha. Suddha Bhakata Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula Bhakata Seva Parama Siddhi Prem Bhakti Prem Latikera Mula Prem Latik Bhakti Lata. Same thing. So we have to attend Sadhu Sangha. So how we can attend Sadhu Sangha? This is a sequence. We need to have a Sadhu Sangha. So where, how we can find, how we can get Sadhu Sangha? Then again scripture says that Krishna Bhakti Unmukhi Sukruti can enable us to associate with devotees. Sukrut means piety, pious credit. So there are many, many kinds of sukruti, punya karma, piety, many kinds of piety. And all these piety have a different destination. They can take you to different destination. Swarga, many times nark also. Especially swarga, piety can take you to swarga. Chine punye tetam bhuktva swargalokam vishalam chine punye mrityulokam vishantita itram aitrai dharmanu prapanna gatagatam kama kama labhante. So that kind of piety will not help you to have a sadhu sang, to enable you to have a sadhu sang. It will not qualify you to have a sadhu sangha. It has to be bhakti unmukhi sukruti. What is that bhakti unmukhi sukruti? That by some means we have contacted something in relations to Krishna, like prasadam, knowingly, unknowingly, like taking a dip into Mother Ganga, Jamuna, or by hearing Harinam on the street. So this is piety, but it is not intentional. And if it is intentional, then you will get right away. Somehow or another, we must have contacted Bhakti Unmukhi Sukruti, that punya karma which is in connection with Krishna, knowingly or unknowingly. So that piety can enable us to have sadhu sangha, because it will attract sadhu to ourselves. I gave $1 donation in 1970. $1 donation to the Sankirtan party in St. Louis in front of famous and bar downtown. I was new. in the town also, almost student. But I like it. And they gave me Krishna storybook, that John Harrison. Anyway, somehow or other, I was attracted. And I gave $1 donation. Those days for a student, dollar is a very big thing. But that is a unmukhi sukruti. So then that draw me into the center, which were nearby. Like that. Somehow or other there is no intention of doing bhakti, but we somehow or other get connected. So like that. Let's see the sequence again. Then we will discuss a little more. The original question is that we are spirit soul. Who we are? We are spirit soul, Atma. And by nature, Atma is seeking total satisfaction, total bliss. That's a nature. So then, that can be only found if we can Atma samprasidati, savai punso paridharmo, yado bhakti radaksaje. By rendering transcendental, loving, devotional service, which is uninterrupted and unmotivated. By that bhakti, one can get total satisfaction. So where can we get that bhakti? That bhakti we can find or we can get in sadhu sangha. So then how we can get a sadhu sangha? Bhakti, unmukhi sukruti. Somehow or another, this life or past lives, we must have done some piety in connection with Krishna, knowingly, unknowingly. And knowingly, even if you do, if you give sadhu a dollar donation or whatever, prasadam, roti, kapda, makan, something, then that sadhu will be attracted towards us. We will invoke some kind of loving reciprocation there between us and a sadhu. Sadhu's work is only one. How I can give devotional service to all living entities, connect them back to Krishna. So, then the question is, who is sadhu? Who is sadhu? There is no PowerPoint having this kind of projector. So who is sadhu? That's a question. So Krishna defines sadhu in Bhagavad Gita right in the beginning. Well, beginning means in middle, 9th chapter. He says, apichet sudhuracharo bhajate mam ananya bhak sadhu reva samantavya samyak vavasito isaha kshipram bhavati dharmatma sasvat santim nigacchati kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasyati. So this is sadhu. Sadhu's definition by Krishna. Mantavya. His strong mantavya. Opinion. In his opinion, in Krishna's opinion, sadhu is one who is ananya bhakta of Krishna. Apichet sudurachar. Bhajate mam ananya bhak. Sadhu reva samantavya. Samyak vyavasito isaha. sadhu reva. So sadhu means he has to be unalloyed devotee. He has to be ananya bhakta, ananya bhakta. Ananya bhakta of Krishna, ananyata is defined by Narada Muni in Narada Muni Sutra, Narada Bhakti Sutra. Anya asraya tyago ananyata. Anya asraya tyago ananyata. Asraya, shelter. No other shelter than Krishna. That is sadhu. Ananyata. Anya asraya tyago ananyata. Only Krishna. Mere to giradhar gopal, dusro na koi. Ananyata. Paranu to pritama pyaro, akhanda saubhagya maro. If I have to marry, I will marry Krishna. Why? Because he is eternal. Randavanu bhayatadari. He is not going to die. Ananyata. Ananya asraya tyago ananyata. So this is sadhu. Sadhu is one who is ananya bhakta of Krishna and only Krishna. So this is sadhu. Sadhu doesn't mean long beard, white long beard, and matted hair, and nanga, maybe naked, and saffron, or danda, or brown, yellow, black skin. Sadhu means one who is ananya bhakta of Krishna. Long beard, white hair, matted hair, he may be sadhu, he may not be sadhu. But one who is unalloyed, one who is ananya bhakta, he is sadhu. Doesn't matter, he has a long ear, long beard, long anything. He has to be ananya bhakta of Krishna. Then that is a sadhu. Apichat sudurachar, he says, Krishna says, don't mind if he has a little fault here and there. Why? Because kshipram bhavati dharmatma sasvat santim nigacchati. He will come to his sadhu position in no time. He will come back. He will rectify himself. He will correct himself. So this is sadhu. Sadhu means he must be Vaishnava. Out of all four sampradaya, any sampradaya, they are sadhus. And if they are not devotees of Krishna, we due respect to them, but they are not considered to be sadhu. We respect them. We respect everybody. Religionist, Christian, Muslim, Hindu, Sikh, Isai. We respect. But sadhu means he should be devotee, unalloyed devotee. He should be ananya bhakta. So this we have to fix first. Otherwise, it will go nowhere. He has to. Vaishnava means two things. He has to get Vaishnavi Diksha and he must chant Vaishnava mantra, Vishnu Krishna's mantra. And third, he must worship Vishnu Krishna. This is Vaishnava. So these are the Vaishnavas, are the sadhus. And others, a spiritualist, we may respect, but not worthy of taking association. So, sadhu, sadhu must be having good symptoms. Who is sadhu? We have to know the symptoms of the sadhus. Guna, guna dharma of a sadhu. Titikshva karunaika sruhut sarvadehinam ajata satravah sadhu. Ajata satravah santa sadhavah sadhu bhushanam. Sadhu has to be titikshva. He must be very tolerant. Titikshva means even there is a reason to become angry, you don't become angry. That is titiksha. Just like Jesus Christ was kneeled down on the cross and he's praying to Krishna, "My dear Lord, they don't know what they are doing. Please forgive them." This is titiksha. Karuna, karuna, this is karuna. Haridas Thakur was beaten up in 22 marketplace and he's pretending as if he's dead to save the soldiers being beaten up by king. This is titiksha. Very tolerant, titiksha. Karunaika, karuna. He is most merciful. It can be different level of karuna. And most merciful devotee is a sadhu. Karunaika. Srut sarvadehinam. He is friend to all living entity. Sruhud sarvadehinam. Ajata satravah santo sadhavah sadhubhushanam. Ajat satru. He has no enemy. Srila Prabhupada said, "I have no enemy, but because people are thinking I am their enemy, I have enemy." Because sadhu has nothing to gain and nothing to lose. So how he can enemy? How he can have enemy? How somebody will envy him? Everything belongs to him, belongs to Krishna. Ajata satravah santo sadhavah sadhu bhushanam. These are the bhushan, ornaments of a devotee. Krishna bhakta niskam. A sadhu has to be niskam, not kami. Kami means gratifying senses, not just one sense, any senses. We have five knowledge acquiring senses. Aak, kaan, naak, jeev, twacha. Any one of these senses, if you gratify, that is kaam. Kami. Niskami. Nirlobhi. Niswadi. That is sadhu. Bhukti, mukti, siddhi, kami, sakale asant. Krishna bhakta niskam atayva sant. This is sadhu. Krishna says, who is sadhu? Nirapeksha munim santam nirvairam nirvairam samadarsana anuvrajamiham nityam puyetya angri renuvi. Krishna is very, very affectionate to his devotees. And he is speaking to Uddhava, 11th canto, 14.16. He is saying, nirapeksha. A sadhu is nirapeksha. He doesn't expect anything from anybody. Not even Krishna, but he is dependent on Krishna. Maravi rakhavi yo ichchatumar nitya dasapati truyadhikara. He is just dependent on Krishna, never expect anything from him, but dependent on Krishna. Nirapeksha. He does not expect anything from anybody. If he expect anything from anybody, that means he becomes corrupt and he cannot preach. He cannot become benevolent. He cannot become he cannot preach, because his motivation is to expect from somebody. So he has to glorify him. He has to, but his real sadhu is nirapeksha. And even if you give to the sadhu, they will engage that thing in Krishna's service. Because he doesn't expect anything for himself. Everything is provided, roti, kapda, makan, simple living, high thinking. Nature provides, Krishna's nature provides, Krishna provides. He learns to depend on Krishna every minute. Srila Prabhupada was dependent on Krishna when he started his journey from here to America. Total dependence. I am the dancing doll in your hand. Please make me dance the way you like it. Make me dance, make me dance. A tool in your hand. Use me. Total dependence, nirapeksha. Munim. Muni, a Vaishnava has to be Muni. Muni means thinker. Muni means he has his own philosophy. Nasya Muni has matam na bhinnam. Muni means his mat has to be bhinnam from other Muni. Different than other Muni. Otherwise he cannot claim to be Muni. Muni. Munim, santam. And our Muni is Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is Mata Manjusa, Aradhya Bhagavan, Rajesatanaya, Taddama Vrindavanam, Ramya Kvachitu Pahasana, Vrajavadu Vargenava Kalpita. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam, Prema Pumartho Mahan, Iti Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Mata, Tatra adara na paraha. This is our Muni. This is our philosophy. I don't want to go in detail of this sloka because it's not in the lecture. Mat, Muni, nirapeksha, qualification of sadhu we are describing. Who is sadhu? Santam, nirapeksha munim santam. A devotee has to be very peaceful, blissful. Santam. He has to be very peaceful. This santa quality of devotee is described in every sloka that describes who is sadhu. The first quality of a sadhu, I would think, is he has to be very peaceful. Nobody can disturb his peace. Nothing can disturb his peace. If somebody is losing his peace, that means he has some intense attachment into something. And we should be only disturbed when it is a problem of somebody is blaspheming Krishna or devotees. Then there is some disturbance in our consciousness. But otherwise he is peaceful. Nirapeksha munim santam. Sant. Asantasya kuto sukham. If he is not sant, then he cannot have peace. I mean, he cannot be happy. Happiness comes from peace. So muni has to be, sadhu has to be sant. 1 kilo ice on his head. He is cool-headed. No disturbance. Munim santam nirvairav. And he has no enmity to anybody. He has no enemy, nowhere. Nirvairam. Samadarsanam. He is equipoised to every living entity. Because he has nothing to gain, nothing to lose from anybody and everything. Nirapeksha. So he can become equipoised. Samadarsana. Vidyavinaya sampane brahmane gaviyasine. Sunichaiva supakecha panditaha samadarsina. Samdars. Then Krishna says, behind such devotees, I walk, I run. Anuvrajami, anuvraj, vrajami, to go, chalna, anuvrajami. I follow their footsteps. Why I follow footsteps? Anuvrajami, aham nityam, always. I follow the footsteps of my devotees, Vaishnava devotees, sadhus. Anuvrajami aham nityam puyayatya angri renu bhi. Puyayatya, pavitra. It purifies. Angri renu, his dust of his lotus feet purifies me. In another word, purifies what is within me, what is within Krishna. And that's why Krishna is following the footsteps of his pure devotees. Anuvrajami aham nityam puyetya angri renu bhi. Bhagavatam 11.14.16. So his kripalu, devotees are always merciful, humble, truthful, equal to all, faultless, magnanimous, mild and clean. They are without material possessions and they perform welfare work for everyone. They are peaceful. The santa, peaceful, I said that. It comes in every sloka, santa. Is peaceful, surrendered to Krishna and desireless. Desireless means sadhu always desires in the benefit of Krishna. Desireless means he always desires in connection with Krishna. So that's why he is called desireless. They are different to material acquisitions and are fixed in devotional service. They completely control the 6 bad qualities, lust, anger, greed, and so forth. They eat only as much as required. And they are not inebriated. They are respectful, grave, compassionate, and without false prestige. They are friendly, poetic, expert, and silent. I'll skip some of the qualities of Vaishnavas or sadhus because so much glorification is there in scriptures about sadhus. Even Krishna glorifies, just like a previous sloka. Krishna always glorifies his devotees. So, what are the glories of devotees? Krishna says, Name bhakta chaturvedi mad bhakta svapacha priya tasmai deyam tato grahyam sacha pujyo yathahi aham. So this is glories of devotees. Krishna says, My devotees are as worshipable as I am. And some places he says, my devotees are even more worshipable than I am. Because you can get devotional service, bhakti from them. Of course we have to worship Krishna. So, name abhakta chaturvedi mad bhakta svapacha priya. A Brahman who is expert in four Vedas, if he is not my devotee, he is not dear to me. But a chandala, a dog eaters, swapacha, dog, swa means dog, pacha, eater, swapacha priya. Tasmai deyam tato grahyam. Sacha pujyo yathahi aham. Tasmai deyam. We must give him whatever charity we can or he needs. Tasmai tato grahyam. And we should accept everything from him, such as dust of his lotus feet, Nirmalya, his clothing, or any tatogram, whatever he gives us, especially Krishna consciousness. His interest is to give us Krishna. Ekaki amar nahi paye bala, hari nama sankirtane, tumi kripakari, sraddha bindu diya deha Krishna namadane, Krishna se tomar, Krishna ditte par, तुम्हारा सकतिया छे अमी तो कंगाल कृष्ण कृष्ण बोली धाये तब पाछे पाछे. दिस इज व्हाट दे गिव साधुस. दे गिव अस दिस तस्मै देयम ततो ग्राह्यम. वी शुड गेट फ्रॉम देम दिस थिंग्स. सच पूज्यो यथा ही अहम. दे आर एज वर्शिपेबल एज आई एम. He says in Amrish Maharaj's Yakhyan, he says, Sadhavo Hrudayam Mahiyam. This is, we are describing the glories, how glorious devotees are, how exalted, why we should associate with them. What kind of position they have. So it is very important that we learn the glories of sadhus, Vaishnavas. So, he says to Durvasa Muni, he is addressing Durvasa as a Brahman, not as a devotee. He says, Brahman. Sadhava Rudayam Mahiyam. Sadhus are in my heart. Sadhavo Hrudayam Mahiyam. Sadhutva Rudayam Chaham. And I am in their heart. That means they both are one. In love. They are in each other's heart. Tumare Radaya Sada Govinda Vishram. Govinda Kahena Vaishnava Murapran. Madanyat na janati naham tevyo manakabi. They don't know anything but me, and I don't know anything but them. So Krishna's meditation is on his devotees, and devotees' meditation is on Krishna. Sadhava hrudayam mahyam, sadhutva hrudayam ham. Madanyat na janati naham tevyo manakabi. So Yudhishthira Maharaj is glorifying sadhus, his uncle, sadhu uncle, Vidurji. And he says, Bhagavad Vida Bhagavatas, Tirthi Bhutani Swayam Vibho, Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Swantas Tasta Gadabritaha. Because you are carrying Lord Sri Krishna in your heart, you are a walking tirtha. Tirthe kurvanti tirthani. Because you are, in another word, Krishna is in everybody's heart, every living entity's heart. So what is special about Krishna being in Vidura's heart? So he says, Svantastasta Gadabhruta. He says, Lord is there in your heart, and he is always manifest, dormant, sleeping and wake up. So Krishna is not sleeping in your heart, he is manifest. In devotee's heart, Krishna is manifesting himself. He is awake. He is reciprocating with devotee. He is not dormant. He is interacting with his devotees. And that's why devotees are walking tirtha. Tirtha means wherever there is Krishna, Krishna's lotus feet, Krishna's leela, Lord has performed some pastimes, that becomes tirtha. So in devotee's heart, Lord is manifested himself and executing all these activities. That's why a devotee is sadhu. Krishna manifests. Bhagavad Vida Bhagavatas Tirthe Bhuta Swayam Vibho Tirthe Tirthi Kurvanti Tirthani Antastasta Gadabhruta. Lord has manifest himself in your heart. That's why you are walking tirtha. Mostly Krishna is glorifying here the sadhus. Krishna is talking about sadhus. Name yatha me priyatam. This is a very beautiful statement of Krishna. It is 11:14:15, Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna says, Na tatha me priyatam. Nobody is as dear to me as devotees like yourself. My devotees is very dear to me. Na tatha me priyatam. Na yathame priyatam atma yonir na sankara. Atma yoni means Lord Brahma, who is born of Krishna, Vishnu, Garbhodakshay Vishnu. So na yathame priyatam atma yonir na sankaro. My son Lord Brahma is not as dear to me as devotees, my devotees. Sankaro, my very soul, my very Atma, Lord Shiva, Vaishnava Nam Yatha Sambhu, Lord Shiva is not as dear to me as my devotees. Na yatha me priyatam, Atma yonir na sankaro, na sankarsano, na sankarsano. Sankarsan is Lord Balaram. His brother, Lord Balaram, is not as dear to me as my devotees. Na cha sankarsano, na Sri Bir. Sri, my wife, Lakshmi, is not as dear to me as devotees, my devotees. Na Sribi, naivatma yatha bhavan, naivatma yatha bhavan. My dear, my very soul, Krishna and his soul has no difference, but he is saying here, naivatma, my soul is even not dear to me, naivatma yatha bhavan, as much as my devotees are dear to me. And then that sloka, nirpeksha munin santam nirvairam samadarsana anuvrajami ham nityam puyayatya angri renubhi. Krishna says, I follow the footsteps of my such devotees so that it can purify. So such is the glories of his devotees. Of course, they are all devotees. Shankar is devotee, Brahma is devotees, and Sri is devotee, and Balaram is devotee. But he is glorifying devotees. Na tatha me priyatam, atma yonir na sankaro, na sankarsano, na Sri bir, naivatma yatha bhavan. My devotees are more dear to me than these personalities. So this glorification is also endless. So I'm going to skip because 6:39. We have to stop at 7, is it? 7? Okay. So I think we are going to go halfway. Maybe not even that. So I'll skip so many discussion here and let's go to what Sadhu Sangha can award us. What Sadhu Sangha can give us. So Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sanghe Krishna Bhakti Shraddha Yadi Hoy, Krishna Bhakti Phal Prema Hai, Bhakti Phal Prema Hai, Samsar Ayakshai. Sadhu Sanghe Krishna Bhakti Shraddha Yadi Hoy. If you have full faith in sadhus. Now sadhu, who is sadhu? All these terms is sadhu. Vaishnava is sadhu. Guru is sadhu. Sant, Mahant is sadhu. But don't forget, he has to be a devotee of Krishna, Vishnu. So sadhu sanghe Krishna bhakti shraddha yadi hai, bhakti phal prem hai, samsar ayakshai. So sadhu sangha can award us Krishna prem. Ado shraddha tatha sadhu sangha tatha bhajana kriya anartha nivrutti syat tatha nishta ruchi tatha sakti tatha bhav abhidanchanti sadhakanam yam premna pradurbhave bhavet krama. So right in the beginning, sadhu sangha. Ado Shraddha, and Shraddha definition of Shraddha is also saying, Krishna is in right in the middle. Whatever Krishna says, you accept that without question. That is Shraddha. Whatever is said in the scripture, you accept that. Especially Bhagavat and Gita. That is Krishna's words. So that is Shraddha. Shraddha sabde vishwas kare. Sudrada nischai. Krishna bhakti kaile sarva karma krita. Hai. So, sadhu sanghe Krishna bhakti Shraddha adi hai. Bhakti phal prem hai. Sansar yaikshai. No more birth, death, old age and disease. Sadhu sangh Krishna bhakti. Sadhu sangh, sarva sastra koi, lava matra sadhu sangha, sarva siddhi hoy. It enables, sadhu sangh enables us to have all perfection, especially Krishna prema. So now, who desires sadhu sangha? So we all, if Krishna manifests in front of you and asks you a boon, please ask me boon, I want to give you boon. So what boon we should ask? So people have different idea. What did you say? Somebody said something. Huh? Very good. He's trained by me. Tandera charana sevi bhakta sannivas janam janam hoy ehi abhilash. Ek abhilasha. Tandera charan. Tandera charan means the servant of those six Goswamis. That is Tandera. Servant of six Goswamis. Tandera charana sevi bhakta sannivas. Which bhakta sannivas? Tandera charana sevi bhakta sannivas. No other sadhu. Tandera charana sevi bhakta sannivas. Prabhupada said that demigods are lining up. Actually, everybody is lining up to take birth in ISKCON. Because of sadhu sangha. Tandera charana sevi bhakta sanne. Kita janma hau yathatuya das. Bahirmukha brahma janme nahi ash. So even if I have to become kita, let it be in the house of your devotee. So that I will not miss you. Every minute, prasadam, kita, if you are chitti, if you are an ant, in a devotee's house, you will have prasadam, you will hear Krishna katha, you will see every Krishna center oriented activities. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, kita janma havu yathatuya das, bahirmukha brahma janme nahi as. Lord Shiva also is hankering for devotees' association. Lord Brahma also prayed the same thing. Lord Indra also prayed the same thing. Please give me the association of your devotees. So that should be our aspiration. That should be our strong desire. Please, give me the association of devotees. One moment without the association of devotees, loss, one moment, we lose billions and billions of dollars. That kind of distress should be there. I'm sorry to give my example, but I never wanted to live 1 inch away from the temple, being grahastha also. Because of the sadhu sangha. Beautiful. Sadhu Sangha. Of course, we have to learn the art of associating with devotees. We will touch that point if we can come to that. Let's go fast and come to that point also. So Sadhu Sangha is very important. Sadhu Sanghas, Nama Kirtan, Bhagavat Sravan, Mathura Vas, Sradaya Srimurtir Sevan, Sakala Sadhana Sreshta, Ehi Panchanga. Krishna Prem Janmaya, Ehi Panchera Alpa Sangha. Even fraction of moment, if we have association with these five limbs of devotional service, which includes Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoy. Krishna Prem Janmaya, Alpa Sangha. Even if you have a little opportunity to have association with these five things, Sadhu Sangha, Nama Kirtan, Bhagavat Sravan, Mathura Vas, and Sri Murtir Sevan. Sakala Sadhana Shrest, Ehi Panchanga. Krishna Prem Janmaya, Ehi Panchera Alpa Sangha. Ado Shraddha, Sudha Bhakata Charan Renu, Kona Bhagye Karo Samsara, Shai Unmukhai, Sadhu Sanghe Tabe Krishna Rati Upjaye. Rahu Ganat Tapasha Na Yati, Nacha Ijya Naivar Pranat, Grihatva, Na Chandasa Naiva Jalagni Suryor, Vina Mahatpad Rajo Vishekam. Not just touch the lotus feet of a devotee and have a one drop of dust of his lotus feet. But Rahugan, King Rahugan, Jadbharat Maharaj says, Vina Mahat Pad Rajobi Abhishekam. Abhishek we have seen today. Beautiful Abhishek. So you have to smear whole body. Not smear, Abhishek means bathing. One must bathe in the dust of the lotus feet of a devotee. Vina Mahat Pad Rajobhishekam. That's a mercy we should aspire for. So, types of devotees. We have 10 minutes. So, I'll skip these types of devotees, you know, first class, third class, second class devotees from Nectar of Instruction. And mind you, third class devotee is also more glorious than we think of. Third class devotee is not, third class devotees of Krishna is more exalted than billions of people. Don't put third class to the third class, so-called third class level. Anyway, I'm going to skip these three. But it's very important to know about all these three kind of devotees so that you can associate with them at their level and serve them at their level. And Rupa Goswami is detailed in Nectar of Instruction. He says, he says three kinds of devotees and then how to associate with them. And I'm sure you have studied that. I'm going to skip this. So, let's go to the offense. Last 10 minutes. Actually, I should give you time for questions, but I didn't plan my lecture properly here. So, offenses, there are six offenses of the devotees, and I want you to memorize this sloka. It is in Chaitanya Charitamrita, purport of 2.15.261. Who will memorize this sloka in 1 year time? Offenses against devotees. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's it. Others are... Just show your hand like this. Not much. Sleeping, so... Okay, let me explain you, then you might be ready. So he says, there are six kind of offenses. Offenses against the devotees. Hanti, Nindati, Vaidvesti, Vaishnavana Abhinandati, Krandati Upajayate Naharsam, Darsane Patanani Sat. If you become angry at the devotees, that's a Vaishnava Prad. Hanti. Hanti means pitai. Hanti means beat up a devotee. Hanti, nindati, blaspheming a devotee. Hanti, nindati, vaidvesti, to criticize unnecessarily devotee. Hanti, nindati, vaidvesti, vaishnavana, abhinandati, that you don't greet a devotee by saying, Hare Krishna Prabhu, Hare Krishna. So you greet devotee like that. But if you don't greet a devotee with Hare Krishna, then you are offending a devotee. Hanti, nindati, vaidvesti, vaishnavana, abhinandati, abhinandan. Greeting a devotee. Na abhinandati. Krandati, to become angry at devotee. Jayate na harsam. Darsane, yati no harsam, darsane patanani sam, sat. Upon seeing a devotee, you don't become very jubilant, happy, smiling, and genuine, happiness. Genuinely you should be happy. Harsam. Krandite yati no harsam, darsane. Upon having darshan of a devotee, you don't become jubilant. That is Vaishnava Prada. So, if you do this Vaishnava Prada, then what is the punishment? That you go to the hell. Which hell? Maharaurav Samjite. You go to which hell? And with who? He says, Patanti Pitruvi Sardham. Patanti Pitruvi. So you go to the Maharaurav hell with your ancestor. What they have done wrong for, but this is a danda. This is punishment. You go along with your ancestor to the hell. And what are the six offenses? Hanti, Nindati, Vaidvesti, Vaishnavana Abhinandati, Krandati, Jayate na harsam, darsane, Upajayate na harsam, darsane, Patanani. And where Patan? Which hell? And with who? With who? Okay, so CC 215-261 purport. I would humbly urge you to memorize this sloka. It's very important for being a ISKCON devotee. We want to avoid this totally. Very good. Madhya Lila, 15 chapter, 261. So, who will memorize this sloka in 1 year time? Still not enough hand. Not enough hand. Why you won't memorize this? If you memorize this, our movement will go far, wide, speedily, very. But I wrote this book called Sadhu Sangha. It is available here. You can take it for 150 rupees. Very inexpensive. It's a very good book. And how to deal with devotees, how to art of dealing with devotees, what are the three kinds of devotees, what scripture says about them, and learning art of dealing with devotees. Everything is beautifully described in this book called Sadhu Sangha. And then I have a book, Anand Ki Aur, Bliss and Beyond, and Maya Ki Mar, and Man Ki Manmani, and so many books are on my table here. So you are welcome to buy one. Any quick question before Maharaj comes? We have 4 minutes. Any quick question? Yes, doctor?
What is the reason that...
Where is the microphone? Here. Whoa. Okay, say it. Start saying it. We don't have much time.
So first, I want to thank for such a nice lecture on Sadhu Sangha. Thank you very much. So my point is that why this happens after so much staying in ISKCON for such a long time, still these ecstatic symptoms are not coming. But you were mentioning in your lecture, after staying in ISKCON for such a long time.
Why this? Because of mainly Vaishnava Aparad, then maybe Nama Aparad, then maybe Seva Aparad, then maybe Dham Aparad. Aparad. But mainly Vaishnava Aparad. Very delicate issue. We have to learn the art of dealing with devotees at their level. Sakale sanman karitos. We didn't touch all these things, but it is in the book. Sakale sanman korito sakati deho nata jatha jatha. Tabito gaibo harinama sukhe aparada avihatta. Any other question? Yes? Saranagati? Saranagati? Jump.
Hare Krishna, thank you very much Maharaj for such a wonderful lecture. My question is, Maharaj, sometimes we knowingly or unknowingly do the Vaishnava Aparad. This becomes our tendency. How to get rid of this tendency?
Very easy. Not to get into this tendency. We get into it. So we should be very, very careful. Extremely careful. Haristane aparade. Finished. It's finished. So we should be very, very extremely careful. Krishna aparad. Krishna will forgive. Why? Because why this tumasthane aparade nahi paritran? Why? Because Krishna loves his devotees more than himself. More than yad na yathame priyatam na atma yonir sankaro na sankarsano na sribir naivatma yatha bhavan. He loves more than. So if you offend a child may forgive you, but mother will never forgive you. Krishna will never forgive you. You have to be very careful. And that's why I wrote this book. That was the purpose of writing this book. Very beautiful book. I saw that in ISKCON, still I see. I'm sorry to say on dais while this lecture, but we are not together. We have so much amongst ourselves, which is not good. And that's why I wrote this book. Please take it home and practice it. Any other question?
Hare Krishna.
Quick question.
One devotee asking in Bengali. So the question is, in preaching field, some devotees we see.
Some devotees?
They won't. We see some few devotees. That they
some,
won't.
Some devotees what?
We see.
We see.
We see. Means he has seen that.
He sees
that they won't help in the preaching. So after seeing them, we won't feel jubilant or ecstatic or happy.
No, that's
and
wrong.
We don't even respect.
I understood. Don't expect devotees to come and preach every time and any time you like. Temple devotees are very limited. I hope he's talking about temple devotees. They are very limited. They are totally up to here in their services, whether they are on the road or they are inside. And that's why Bhakti Vruksha means you. If you don't know how to preach and talk and give a talk, and then read from Prabhupada books, but don't expect them. It is not right.
Do you like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.